It fell about the Martinmas, when the wind blew shrill and called, said Ida McGordon to his men, "We maun draw to a halt. And what na halt saw we draw to, my merry men and me? We will gae to the House of the Roads, to see that fair lady." The lady stood on her castle wa, beheld baith dale and down. There she was aware of a host of men came riding towards the town. "O see ye not, my merry men, O see ye not what I see? Methinks I see a host of men, I marvel who they be." She weened it had been her lovely lord, as he came riding hame. It was the traitor, Ida McGordon, warak nor sin nor shame. She had not sooner busked herself, and putten on her gown, till Ida McGordon and his men were round about the town. They had nae sooner supper set, nae sooner said the grace, but Ida McGordon and his men were lighted about the place. The lady ran up to her tower head, as fast as she could hie, to see if by her fair speeches she could why him agree. "Come doon to me, ye lady gay, come down, come doon to me. This night saw ye lay within mine arms, tomorrow my bride saw be. I winna come down, ye false Gordon, I winna come down to thee. I winna forsake my ain dear lord, and he is not far frae me. Gie o'er your house, ye lady fair, gie o'er your house to me, or I saw burn your cell therein, but in your babies three. I winna gie o'er, ye false Gordon, to nae sick dratter as thee, and if ye burn my ain dear babes, my lord saw mock ye three. Now reach my pistol, glow, my man, and charge ye wheel my gun, for, but an I pierce that bloody butcher, my babes, we been undone." She stood upon her castle wa, and let wa bullets flee. She missed that bloody butcher's heart, and only raised his knee. Set fire to the house. Quo Fos Gordon, "What why do lay an ire, Fos lady? Ye saw rue that shot as ye burn in the fire. We worth ye, Jock, my man. I paid ye weel your fee, why pull ye at the grun wa stain, let's in the reek to me. And e'en we worth ye, Jock, my man. I paid ye weel your hire, why pull ye at the grun wa stain, to me let's in the fire. Ye paid me weel my hire, lady, ye paid me weel my fee, but now I'm Ida McGordon's man, maun either do or dee." Then bespake her little son, sat on the nurse's knee, says, "O mither dear, gee o'er this house, for the reek it smothers me. I wad gee my goat, my bairn, say wad I my fee, for a blasted the western wind, to blaw the reek frae thee." Then bespake the daughter dear, she was baith jimp and small apostrophe colon o romi in a pair of sheets, a tomi o'er the wa apostrophe exclamation mark. They rode her in a pair of sheets, and towed her o'er the wa, but on the point of Gordon's spear she gat a deadly faw. O bonny, bonny was her mouth, and cherry were her cheeks, and clear, clear was her yellow hair, whereon her red blood dreeps. Then why his spear he turned her o'er, O gin her face was wan. He said, "Ye are the first that e'er I wished alive again." He came and looked again at her, O gin her skin was white. "I might hae spared that bonny face to hae been some man's delight. Busk and bone, my merry menna, for ill dooms I do guess, I cannot look on that bonny face as it lies on the grass. Wa looks to freights, my master dear, its freights will follow them." Let it ne'er be said that Ida McGordon was daunted by a dame. But when the lady saw the fire come flaming o'er her head, she wept, and kissed her children twain, says, "Bairns, weepin' but dead." The Gordon then his bugle blew, and said, "Awa, awa, this house of the roads is in a flame. I hauled it time to gae apostrophe. In this way look at her ain dear lord." As he came o'er the lee, he saw his castle in a low, say far as he could see. Put on, my whitey men, as fast as ye can dree, for he that's hindmost of the thrang saw ne'er get good o' me. Then some they rode, and some they ran, out o'er the grass and bent, but ere the foremost could win up, baith lady and babes were brent. And after the Gordon he is gane, say fast as he might dree, and soon aye the Gordon's foul heart's blood he's roken his fair lady.